It's time to prepare your brain for information about the KTM 2018 off-road lineup.
Yeehaw! We gonna be mixing gas and hauling out.
Wait, that 250 XC-W TPI is actually gonna mix the oil in the gas for us, so I guess we won't be mixing gas. But we'll still be going super fast, man.
We gonna pan this sucker. Woo!
That's really loud in this shop, just so you know. That's probably enough screwing around for one day. Thanks for tuning in. I'm Kyle with Dirt Bike Channel, your host, and today we're going to be talking again, like I said, about those 2018 KTM off-road bikes, specifically the two-stroke bikes, because those are the ones that I'm mostly interested in. Those are the ones where we have the big news. If you read the press releases and stuff, there's not a ton of changes that are happening from the 2017 models to the 2018 models, except for, we'll get into those little changes, except for the KTM 250 XC-W TPI. This is the fuel injected version. It's the first time that KTM has done it. It's the first time anyone really of the major manufacturers, any of our dirt bike manufacturers, have made a fuel injected bike and a two-stroke, and that is coming. Right off the bat, I noticed something kind of interesting. According to the press release, that bike is 227 pounds, which makes it 6.5 pounds heavier, according to KTM. Now, I haven't had it on my scales yet, as you know, the bikes are actually heavier when they're put on my scale. I weigh them full of fuel, but the bike, according to KTM, that injected model, a fuel injected model, is exactly, just looking at my notes here, yeah, 6.5 pounds heavier. So I said they're gonna be more expensive. They are. They haven't told us how expensive it's gonna be, but they've now told us that it's at least 6.5 pounds heavier just to get that fuel injection. With the fuel injection though, that means that you're no longer gonna be jetting your carburetor because it doesn't have a carburetor. And it's also going to have, claimed, a little bit more fuel efficiency. So that sucker is going to be adjusting for altitude, it's gonna be adjusting for barometric pressure. They're talking about 5 different sensors that this bike is going to have in order for that ECU to give the proper mapping for the fuel mixture and the oil mixture. They're saying that you're going to have sensors on the ambient air pressure, the throttle position, the oil temperature, and the, what was the other one? Oh, and the water temperature. So there's a bunch of different sensors around there to kind of make that thing work good. And hopefully it does. I mean, honestly, I think this KTM 250 XE, this is a 2017, this thing runs phenomenal. It didn't take me long to get that McCuney dialed in, and it runs unbelievable. And so did the 300 two-stroke that I had, the 300 XC that I had before that. So this you know, fuel injected model has got a lot to live up to in my mind, because I haven't had any problems with the carburetors. But they're also saying that with that oil injection system, because it's going to be mixing the oil for you, there's a 700 cc oil reservoir that's supposed to last around, they're saying, about maybe 5 fuel tanks. So your oil reservoir, you'll put the oil into the oil reservoir, and that is going to mix with your gas for you, and it maybe up to 5 tanks. They're saying that it's going to have a decrease in the emissions, you know, that come out. Of course, that's the big thing here. These bikes had to become Euro 4 compliant, these stringent emission laws in Europe. And so that's kind of the big thing that's been driving this in order for injection to come to these two strokes. So that is what we know, is that the bike is supposed to have less smoke. It's supposed to be more fuel efficient and all those things. It's gonna be fitted with a Del Orto. I'm not exactly sure how you pronounce that, but it's a Del Orto 39 millimeter throttle body. So that'll be the thing feeding into the motor. It's an all new motor. It's different than the motors that we've seen in the past. Everything, there's a lot of stuff that's different. It's a new cylinder, it's a new piston. There's 2 injectors on the back of that motor, and they're injecting the fuel and the air into those transfer ports. That's gonna help to atomize the fuel, according to what they say. And again, I'm excited to see this. We're only getting one model. So there's gonna be carbureted bikes, there's gonna be this one EFI bike, the KTM 250 XC-W TPI. The TPI stands for transfer port injection. They're going to be in very limited numbers from what I've been told. I'll be lucky if I get my hands on one, probably won't. KTM, if you're listening, I would love to purchase one and review it. So if you guys are listening out there, enough about that EFI bike. Let's talk about some of the things that are happening on the XC, like the 250 XC, like this bike, and the 300 XC. Not a ton is happening. They're talking about updating some of the Mikuni TMX carburetor settings to make it start easier. I'm not really sure what that means because it starts really easily anyway, especially if you jet it like I've got these things jetted. They're very easy to do. To jet that way. But they are saying that they've turned the carburetor 7 degrees to reduce fuel overflow. So I don't know, it sounds like a good thing. If it's gonna stop dumping a little bit of gas, that can't be a bad thing. They're also claiming that they've got some updated settings for these AER 48 forks. These air forks on the 2017s have been un-freaking believable. And I have not seen another bike yet that is as good as that. The Yamaha SSS forks might be as good. They might be a little better in certain situations, but I have freaking loved the air forks. They also say that they've got some updated damping settings for the rear shock. So they're continuing to try to improve that, but it's basically the same thing with maybe a little bit different valving. They're talking about new radiator guards. So they're talking about radiator guards across the entire lineup. So I don't know exactly what that's supposed to do. They're saying it's gonna help, you know, so mud doesn't get in there. So all these bikes are gonna come with new radiator guards. They also say they're going to put on a new CDI unit for better starting. And again, these bikes, in my opinion, I haven't had any problem with them starting. Maybe some of the four strokes had a problem starting. I don't know, because I didn't have a 2017 KTM four stroke. I only had 2016s. The price, as near as I could tell, the price on all the bikes went up by about $100 US. That seems to be what they're doing each year, is every year, year after year, the price of the bikes go up by about $100. Again, though, they haven't told us how much the price, what the price is gonna be for that XC-W TPI, the fuel injected model. But what we did hear earlier from one of the KTM's marketing managers, Joaquin Sauer, is that the bike was gonna be along the lines of the four strokes. I think it's going to be over $10,000. Even like the KTM, you know, 300 XC is going to be like $9,300 plus tax and plus all that other stuff. So I think that fuel injected two stroke is going to be in the $10,000 range. You know, I was at a pedal bike shop the other day, and I just saw a Specialized pedal bike, a downhill pedal bike that was like $8,600. So those are crazy expensive. The dirt bikes are crazy expensive. But pedal bikes are even worse, because why would you spend like $8,500 on a bike that doesn't have a motor? I don't know. Anyway, so the bikes are stupid expensive. All these bikes are expensive. Yamaha, Kawasaki, Honda, they're all expensive. And KTM is a little bit more expensive than those guys. But they do put more parts on them. I've done the math. You're getting what you're paying for with KTMs. Honestly, the 2017 KTM two strokes, they are, and I had two of them. I've still got one right here, the 250 and the 300. Those bikes are the most refined and well-rounded two strokes I have ever seen. And I love the crap out of both of them. So they didn't change a ton for 2018 because they had just changed a bunch of stuff in 2017. But that TPI, that 250 XCW TPI, is going to be a freaking hot bike and hard to find, because I just don't think that they have a ton of those. Maybe I'm wrong, but I think it'll be a hard bike to find, and I know everyone's going to be clamoring for it and wanting to test it and see if the EFI is really going to work as well as they say. And maybe, hey, maybe it's going to save two strokes. So there's a lot of pretty cool stuff going on for KTM. The rumors are that, you know, there wasn't a ton of changes for the 2018 model year, but the rumor is that there's going to be a lot of changes for the 2019 model year. As far as the four strokes go, here you go. You've got the 450 XCF, the 350 XCF, and the 250 XCF, as well as the supercross bikes, the motocross bikes, which are the 450 SXF, the 350 SXF, and the 250 SXF. Those are the four strokes. On the two strokes, you've got the cross country side here in the US. That is the KTM 300 XC, standing for cross country, and 250 XC. We have those here in North America. They don't have them in other parts of the world. As far as the enduro bikes, the enduro racing bikes, you've got the 300 XCW, the 250 XCW, the 250 XC-W TPI, which is the transfer port injection one, and then you've got a 150 XC-W. If you're an international, if you're outside the US, like in Europe, or you're in Australia, you have an EXC. The EXC is the same thing as our XC-W. It's a wide ratio transmission. They typically have headlights. They have a tail light there too. So EXC and XCW are basically interchangeable terms. It's just the XCW is here in North America. So that's kind of how that works. Oh, and by the way, there's a brand new from the ground up, all new 85SX. So that bike is all new. It's got a new frame. It's got new motor. It's got all this cool stuff. I've never been around one of the 85s, but KTM seems to be pretty high on that thing. One last thing that I will note is the KTM 300 and 250 XCs. They are stated by KTM to be 10.3 pounds lighter than that fuel injected bike. So the fuel injected bike is, according to KTM, heavier than the carbureted version. It's like 6.5 pounds heavier than its direct brother, like the 250 XCW, and it's over 10 pounds heavier than the XC lineup. So it's crazy. At least they kept Kickstarters. They kept Kickstarters on the two strokes, which I think is awesome. Hopefully they don't do that on this Sherco over here. They've dropped the Kickstarter off that, even though it's a Sherco isn't with KTM. I just happen to have a Sherco behind me. It bugs me that they're dropping Kickstarters off of everything, and I'm glad that at least on the two strokes, we still have the Kickstarter for 2018. And so there should be more information coming in the future. Keep your ear to the ground, but that is what we know now. So thanks for tuning in, guys.
Hey guys, if you didn't already know, Patreon is the best way to support Dirt Bike Channel. We've got some really cool rewards over there. So click on the link up here that you see to become a patron. That'll take you directly to our site and you can check everything out. You can donate as little as $1 per month and it would really, really help us out. Thanks a ton, guys.